गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट मशीन इन द थियरी ऑफ कॉम्पिटिशन, दैट इज नथिंग बट अवर पुश डाउन ऑटोमेटा, दैट इज PDA। सो द मशीन्स सो फार वी हैव डिस्कस, दैट इज योर फाइनाइट स्टेट मशीन, द NFA एंड DFA, दे डू नॉट हैव एनी मेमोरी एसोसिएटेड विद देम, सो वी कैन से दैट दे आर हैविंग लिमिटेड पावर. So the language accepted by that finite automata, whether it is a DFA or NFA, that is nothing but the regular language. But for the context-free languages, the languages which are being generated by our context-free grammar, we require a more powerful machine or more strong machine which can remember the previous input symbol. So the new machine has been introduced, or one can say that slightly modifications has been done in the finite state machine, and that is called as the push down automata, PDA. So the PDA that we are going to discuss in the today's session, so the introduction and the definition of PDA, the construction of PDA, instantaneous description. So PDA described, or the PDA machine or the PDA automata, it is described by the instantaneous description, and the so there are also two types of PDA, that is nothing but the deterministic and the non-deterministic PDA, that is deterministic PDA, DPDA, that is deterministic pushdown automata, and NPDA, non-deterministic pushdown automata, that also we are going to see. And in the final topic is nothing but the post machine in this particular unit. So let us see the definition of pushdown automata. So let us introduce with the pushdown automata, how it is described. So see it carefully. We have studied in the preceding chapters or in the previous chapters that the finite automata, which are computational models that can recognize or accept the regular languages, right? So the finite state machine or the finite automata, just now we have seen that they are going to accept your regular languages, right? But so owing to this, there are also, these are also known as the language acceptor, means we are not going to generate any kind of language from the your finite automata. They are just telling us that whether that particular language is being accepted or it is being rejected by the automata. However, finite state machines have limited memory or limited number of states, already we have seen that, which prevents them from accepting context-free languages, CFL, which are being generated by your context-free grammar. Since memory is a limitation, of finite state machine, it seems reasonable to add a memory element to the finite automata so that a new type of computational model known as push down automata has been developed. Means we have added a memory component to our automata. So it is also called as the stack automata. So memory in which format we have added? So memory in the form of stack. So stack, you know very well, it is nothing but a structure having, you can insert, you can push the element and you can pop the element from that particular stack. So PDA is similar to finite automata, except that it has an extra memory unit, which is known as the stack. Therefore, we can call that PDA is equal to finite state machine plus stack. Stack is defined as a data structure where insertion and deletion of element is possible only at one end, that is called as the top of the stack. This is also, you know, top of the stack, TOS. Only one end is operating here. So this one can say if it is a stack. So from this end, and this is called as the top of the stack, from this end, you are able to insert the element. If you want to remove the element or if you want to pop the element, so that is also possible at this particular end. So PDA is a way to implement the context-free grammar. In a similar way, we design the DFA for the regular grammar. Very important sentence. Just remember this. PDA. So from this push down automata, this is the way, or this is automata to implement our context-free grammar. Remember this point. Remember the difference. Remember the difference between our PDA and the finite automata. Whereas the DFA, deterministic finite automata, or whether it is NFA, finite automata, they are useful to design the regular grammar. Regular grammar, in turn, regular languages, regular grammar, and they identify, or they are able to identify our regular languages. Getting this point? Whereas this PDA, it is implemented for context-free grammar, which in turns identify your context-free languages. That is nothing but your CFL. Right. So remember this point, a very important point as far as your PDA, push-down automata, is concerned. So it is nothing but a finite state machine means it is very similar to your DFA, deterministic or NFA finite state machine, but it is having stack. What happened in case of our DFA? DFA is having, we have the state. Say for example Q0, then we have the state Q1, then we have the state Q2. So limited number of states are there. So as the states are limited, so we can say that as the number of states are limited, the memory amount is limited, or one can say that it does not have any memory to remember the past history. But in case of PDA, as the memory in the form of stack, so it is also called as the auxiliary memory, means the temporary memory we are assigning to the automata, and the automata becomes your powerful one, or one can say that it can remember whatever may be the inputs given in the earlier stages, right? So that's why this makes the PDA more powerful as compared to your DFA, deterministic as well as the non-deterministic finite automata. And as the principle of working of this stack is LIFO, that is last in, first out, the stack provides unlimited memory to the pushdown automata. So PDA can insert or write an element onto the stack. This operation is called as the push operation, and PDA remove or read. So you can call it as a remove, or the PDA read the topmost element from the stack. It is called as the pop operation. So the writing of an element to the stack pushes down all other symbols on the stack. So it is called as the push down automata. So why the name is given as a push down automata? Because if we consider, if it is a stack and if the element is already there, say for example AA is there, and if the new element we are going to push here, so ultimately the remaining two elements are pushing down. They are going down inside the stack. That's why it is called as the push down automata. That's why the name given as a push down automata, which works on the principle of stack. So PDA is nothing but we have provided the memory in the form of stack to the finite state machine or to the automata. Let us go to the next slide here. The class of languages generated by the context-free grammar is larger than the class of languages generated by the regular expression or regular grammar. This implies that all regular languages can be generated by the CFG. Of course, we have seen already the Chomsky hierarchy. Okay, so we can say that regular language is a subset of context-free language. Regular language, one can say that RL, it is nothing but it is a subset of your context-free languages, right? PDA accepts context-free languages. PDA, push-down automata, accepts the context-free languages. Similar to finite automata, PDA may also be deterministic or non-deterministic. Means you have DPDA, that is nothing but deterministic PDA, or you can have NPDA, means you have non-deterministic PDA available. However, important difference again, deterministic PDA and non-deterministic PDA, that is NPDA, they are not equivalent. Remember this point, these are non-equivalent in the power. NPDA recognizes a set of strings which DPDA may not recognize. We cannot convert the NPDA into its equivalent DPDA. The very important point to remember here, though the pushdown automata PDA, it can have the two types. You can have DPDA and you have NPDA, but these are not equivalent in nature. Why? Because the NPDA is having more power as compared to your deterministic pushdown automata. Just like our DFA, in case of our DFA and in NFA, that is deterministic finite automata and non-deterministic finite automata, these two automata, they are equal in power, they are equivalent to each other. In automata, they are equivalent to each other. We can convert DFA into NFA, and NFA into DFA is also possible. Conversion of DFA, NFA, it is possible. But here in this case, conversion to DPD and NPDA, it is not at all possible, as they are having, they are not equivalent, their powers are different. This point you have to remember here. Let us go to the next one. PDA contains three basic components. Now see the component or the architecture of the pushdown automata. First, input tape. Now input tape, it contains the input string bounded at one end and unbounded at the other end, so that any number of characters can read. So it has a input tape. So we can have A here, A here. Then we can have B, B, and it is reading from the tape from left to right hand side direction. Means that input tape. This is your input tape. It have first component which the PDA contains. It contains the input tape, and it starts reading the input tape from the left side to the right hand side. So first A is read here, then second A is read from the input string, then B is read, and this B is now read by your PDA. Then the second very important component is finite control and the scanning head. Finite control and the scanning head. The finite control unit of the PDA represent the states and the transition function. So finite control unit to this particular thing we have here Q0. For example, this is called as the finite control unit that represent the state of that particular push down automata, and the transition function, that is nothing but your delta transition function it represents. While scanning head is used to read the input string starting from the left and moves towards the right. So this particular head start reading the string from the left side and move towards in the right hand direction, whereas this finite control unit will control the state as well as your delta transition. And the input head points to the next input symbol of the input string to be read, right? And the next component, a very important component that PDA has, is nothing but your stack. It is also called as the push down storage, PDS. It is also called as the push down storage. It is used as an auxiliary memory. It is used as an auxiliary memory, or it can be used as a temporary memory. It is possible for the automata to read the data from it and write the data into it. Means you have one more data structure that is called. So you are reading the data. So whatever may be the input string, you are going to read, you are going to push the input character inside this particular stack. You are going to pop the characters from that particular stack. So remember, this PDA push down automata contains three basic components: input tape, finite control that controls your state and transition, scanning head scan the input string from the left hand to right hand direction, and the stack which is nothing but your temporary memory where you can push the elements as well as pop the element from the stack, right? See here. So this is the figure actually. So it has the input tape. So first component is the input tape. So suppose the input tape means it is nothing but the input string. For example, the string is like this, B B A A. So first this B character is being read by the state unit. So for example, if I write here B B then A A. So first character is been read. Say for example, state is Q0 and the stack symbol is here. So this is nothing but the second unit. And that is called as your state unit, and this is nothing but the stack unit. So from the state, it is pushing the element inside the stack, and Z is there. Z indicates Z0, always Z0 indicates the top of the stack, TOS, top of the stack. It is indicated by your Z0, right? So if the symbol B is read by the state Q0, this symbol is to be pushed inside the stack. Now the head moves toward the next input symbol, and this state is, say for example, Q0. Now this symbol, it is again pushed inside the stack here. Say for example, B is here, next input is B. Now A, now the input read is A. Now state changes from Q0 to Q1, and this particular B is popped outside from the stack. This B will be taken outside, because for this A read, we have to take out this B. Go to take out this B. So only one B is in the stack, and the next input symbol is A is read. So you are going to pop that particular B also. So this is the way how the operation takes place, or which are the components. So remember this point: the PDA push down automata consists of input tape, the state unit, the second one, and the third is nothing but the stack. And their operation are like this: first, it will read the first character. Then it go on reading the character second, then third, then four. After reading the character, the state will be there. So as per our rules, as per the production rule, because it also contain the production, it also contain the rule delta transition rules. So we have to change the state. Either it is a Q0 or it is a Q1 or Q2. And you have to push this element into the stack. And at the stack, if there is no content in the stack, it is indicated with the Z0. Means Z0 is the topmost content of the stack, top of the stack, right? So see your formal definition of the PDA. So far we have seen the definition for our DFA, NFA and all other automata. So see here the definition of PDA, it is defined by a tuple Q sigma, then this new character is introduced here, delta Q zero and F. Now capital Q, as everybody knows, that it is nothing but the finite set of state Q zero, Q one, Q two, dot, dot, dot. Sigma is nothing but the finite set of input alphabet. Sigma, capital sigma, is nothing but the finite set of input alphabet. Here also the states are same, input alphabets are also same. Now this next symbol is called as the tau, T-A-U, T-A-U, or it is written, it is drawn like this. For example, it is tau, right? So it has to be written like this. Tau symbol. Tau is nothing but it is the finite set of stack alphabet, means the alphabet which we are going to push inside the stack. The alphabet which we are going to push inside the stack, it is indicated by the symbol. It is indicated by symbol tau, or it is capital tau actually, and it is written this format in the PPT. But while writing in your notebook, you have to write like this. So, right. Then delta, transition function. Now see here, very important transition function. Then Q zero. So see here, transition function is Q, capital Q into input into tau. That gives you Q into tau. Means the current state, the current input symbol, and the topmost stack symbol determines the next move of the PDA. Determines the next move of your PDA. The input symbol, Q, whether it is a Q zero or Q one, then input alphabet, that is whether it is A or B or zero or one, and the tau in the sense the topmost stack symbol. What they determines? They determines the next move. They determine the next move, and also means they determine the next state. That is called as a new state or the next state, and they determines the new stack symbol. For example, NSS. For simplicity, I write here NSS. That is nothing but our new stack symbol, right? So this transition function is very much important as far as our PDA is concerned. Remember this. So Q, capital Q, means the current state into current input symbol into tau. That gives us the next state, new state, into new stack symbol. So what we have to find here with the transition function? So transition function, we have to combine the current input, current stack symbol, and we have to identify what is the next input and what is the next stack symbol. What is the next stack symbol that we have to identify? This is our this particular thing that we have to identify, the next input, sorry, the next state and the next state stack symbol. The Z0 is nothing but the start state symbol in the stack tau. Q0 is the initial state, and F is nothing but the finite set of state. Capital F is nothing but the finite set of state. Okay, so that is the formal definition of the formal definition of your PDA. Remember this: Q, sigma, tau, delta, Q0, and capital F. Only you have to focus on this delta function, where the current state, current input, and current stack symbol uses the new stack symbol and new state. That you have to remember. See here, three actions. So actions performed. Now we have to just identify. We have to just see how the actions are being performed in the PDA. So push action. So push, how we are going to push the element inside the stack. See here, delta transitions in the PDA. Delta Q0A, and always you have to remember this: Q into input into tau. That gives us Q into tau. So this is nothing but your current state. See here, current state. I write here. This is the current input, and this is the current. This is the current stack symbol. And this is nothing but our new state, and this is nothing but the new stack symbol. For simplicity, I have written here. Now observe here. Push action. So push action is happened, or push action is to be taken when the transition is like this. When your current state is Q0, input is A, and stack symbol, this Z0 is nothing but the stack symbol. This is nothing but the stack symbol. This is nothing but the Z. This Z0 is nothing but the tau. Input is nothing but A. So the structure is like this: Q0, A, Z0. Z0 is nothing but the top of the stack. Means initially stack is empty. Initially stack is empty here. For example, stack is empty and the top of the stack is say, for example, Z0. Right? So what will be the next state? So it gives us the next state. It goes to the next state, that is Q1 and AZ0. AZ0 means we are going to push the symbol A into the stack. So my stack becomes, initially it is Z0. So to this transition, when I perform this transition in PDA, I will get the symbol like this, Z0, and input. So the new stack symbol becomes now capital A, and the new state becomes Q1. So I will get here value for Q, capital Q is Q1, and new toe is become my capital A. Means what we are going to do here, we are going to push symbol A into the stack, right? So if current state is Q0, input is A, and the top of the stack TOS is a Z0, then machine goes into state Q1 by pushing A into the stack. So what you have to remember here, for simplicity, you have to remember here, if the transition is like this, so for push action, you have to write down the transition like this, AZ0. So definitely you may change the state or you may not change the state. You have Q0 or Q, and you have to, this is the thing. This operation indicates, this is nothing but your push operation. This is the push operation of the stack. Means this A symbol, it is now push into the stack. So A is currently in the input string. And from the input string, we have push that A inside the stack, right? Now pop action means if we want to pop the symbol from the stack, then how the transition is written. So the delta function is written like this, delta Q0 A Z0, right? So here again, Q0 A Z0 means current state is Q0. The input is A and the toe is nothing but Z0, means it is nothing but the stack symbol. The next state is Q1 and epsilon. So epsilon indicates we are going to pop the element which is at the top of the stack. So in other words, we can say that if we have the transition like this, delta Q0 A Z0 gives us a new state Q1 epsilon. So Q1 epsilon, this output, this indicates your pop operation. This indicates your pop operation. Remember this, you have to by heart this operation, push operation. If this is the case, this A is there, you are going to push inside the stack, and A is not there, Z0, we are going to pop the element which is at the top of the stack, and we are getting epsilon, means we are getting the empty string there in the stack, and this is called as the pop operation. So if current state is Q0, input is A, and the top of the stack TO is Z0, then machine goes to state Q1, the state changes from Q0 to Q1 by popping Z0 from the stack. So Z0 is the last item that is being popped. So currently in the stack, we are getting here empty string. This is the pop operation. And the no operation or NOP, no operation, this is the way. If delta Q1 current state is, for example, Q1 here, A is here, and at the top of the stack, A is there, and you are getting in the same state, and the top of the stack is same. So this two thing means a toe is not being changed here. Toe is not going to change here. A is here and A is here. So this is called as the no operation. We are going to perform no operation here. So this transition is used for the no operation, no push as well as no pop from the stack. Current input, current state is Q0. Current input is small A. Top of the stack is A. Then machine goes into state Q1 by keeping the top of the stack as A only, as a capital A only. Right, so this is nothing but our no operation. So remember this, push action of the stack, pop action of the stack, and the no operation of the stack. Remember this point, right? Now let us go in the more details how the operation is take place. What is the instantaneous description? So instantaneous description in the sense that we have to write the actions performed by the PDA in the form of delta transitions. So let us see. Instantaneous description is useful in showing the processing of the string. Suppose input string is given. So how the input string is parsed, or how the input string is read actually by our PDA. So PDA for A raised to 3, B raised to 3 is shown here. So one example is taken here. A raised to 3 means triple A dot triple B. So how this string is being read by our pushdown automata, how the read operation is being done, and how the stack symbols are being changed here, that we'll see here step by step. So two format of representations are here. First is nothing but the graphical representation, means pictorial representation, you can able to see. And the tuple format representation, tuple format also, we are able to see here. See here, carefully focus on the slide and listen it carefully. So first step. So first, we have the 3A in the inputs currently. So if we clear this particular concept, so rest of the part becomes very much easy for you. So this concept, you must have to clear this. So triple A, triple B. So input string consists of A raised to 3 and B raised to 3. So at the initially, this is the structure input tape. Current state is Q0, and Q0 current state is pointing to first A in the input string. Thus, so this is the second component. And the first third component is the current stack symbol. Z0 is only there in the stack. There is no item is available in the stack. Z0 is there. So I can write like this. This is the third component. This one is the first. So first, second, third. This is the initial position of all the components. So input string, then no letters is being read here. Q0 pointing to first alphabet, and Z0 is the top of the stack. No item currently in the stack. So if the description of the same, if I have to write in the tuple format, so I write in this way. In the tuple format, I write in this way, Q0, triple A, triple B, Z0. So this indicates the current state, this indicates the input string, and this indicates the stack, top of the stack. See here, so graphical format of the PDA, we can write in the tuple format, Q0, that is nothing but the current state of that PDA, the input string given here, and the top of the stack. Now start processing. Now PDA is being started, and it go on reading one by one letter from the input string. So read the first letter. As soon as it read the first letter, see here, input A is read. So we can say input A is read. So Q, and the pointer goes to the next input character, next input alphabet. State is Q0 itself. Q0 is as it is, and this A which has been read, it is pushed inside the stack. So your top of the stack now becomes A. The pointer pointing to the top of the stack is now small A. And in the tuple format, we can write like this. In the tuple format, see here, this is nothing but your state. This is now, see here, this is your input string. So instead of 3A, 1A is now it is pushed into the stack. And the stack becomes like this. This is nothing but your stack. See the difference in writing the tuple format. Observe it carefully. Observe this carefully. Initially, you have 1, 2, 3A, 1, 2, 3B. And there is no symbol in the stack. Only Z0 is there initially. Right. Now, when the machine start reading the string, it reads the first character. First alphabet A is read. So Q0. So this particular A, it is now pushed inside the stacks. That's why AZ0. You have to write this A.Z0. The stack structure becomes A.Z0. And accordingly, A is removed from the input string. Why? Because we have read this A. The A which was here earlier, that is now being pushed inside the stack. Getting this point? Now see here. Now go to the machine. Now the PDA moves to the next character, and the next character is also A. Q0, and this A is this particular A. This A we have pushed it. This A is already we have pushed. So we can say that now the PDA state is Q0 state. It is pointing to the third, but it is pointing, but it is not is being read. It is not yet been read by the PDA. And on the stack we have the 2A and Z0. So this structure is described. This structure is described by the tuple format. Like this, Q0 is the current state, yes, and one more A. So second A we have pushed inside the stack, so the input string remains only A, B, 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 and here see the stack, see the changes in the stack. So you can have 2A, so this is the top of the stack, A, Z0. Getting this point. So my top of the stack now becomes this particular small e. My top of the stack is now small a. So if we observe, so this is the structure like this, a and z0. So here is the structure of stack a, z0. And here is the structure of stack like this, z0. No items is available earlier. Getting this point. Now, getting this point, up to this, it is clear. So, and here we are reducing, or we are removing one character of that particular input string, and that is pushing inside the stack. Means push operations are being carried out by the PDA machine. So see here, next point. Now it moves to the next character, and that character, next alphabet, that is nothing but B. State is Q0, and this particular character, this particular input A, it is now pushed inside the stack. So all the three A are now inside the stack, and my tuple format become a tuple format for this. It is written like this. So at this point of time, we can have Z0, A. So all the three components are there, and the input string. This is the input string. It contains only how many, means how many letters is to be read here. There are A, B, B, B. Only three B that is not yet been read by our PDA, right? So it is pointing to the first, but it is not yet been read. So Q0 is there. So it has to read the B, and the current stack structure looks like this. Triple A, Z0. Getting this point? Now, we'll move to the next one, means read B. Read B, what happens if the machine reads B? So see here, graphical format, tuple format. B is read, and the PDA moves to the next state. So when we read the B, then the state changes from Q0 to Q1. State it changes from Q0 to Q1. And after reading B, we are not going to insert the B inside the stack. Remember this point. When we read this particular B, the state changes from Q0 to Q1. State changes from Q0 to Q1. And this 1A is being popped out. 1A is being popped out for this corresponding B. This is the way how the PDA works. This is the way. We are not going to push the B inside the stack. So see here, the tuple definition, we can have 1B is already read. 1B, so B is read here, so that is removed. And the stack, which was there like this earlier, triple A. So for this corresponding B, this A is now popped from the stack. This A is now popped from the stack. And currently, we have only AAZ0. These much components are there in the stack. And in the input string, double B, the only two Bs are there, that is to be read by the PDA. Getting this point? Meaning for each B, we have to pop one A. For each B, we have to pop one way. 1A, this is the actually the way how the PDA works. This is actually the way how the PDA operates. Means until and unless you encounter B, you go on pushing all the elements inside the stack. And as soon as you encounter B, you have to take the pop operation. You have to take the pop operation. The state changes from Q0 to Q1. And the stack, whatever may be the top of the stack, that is to be removed from the stack itself, right? So see here. The next, now second B is being read, and the pointer moves toward the last character in the B, and the state is Q1 as it is, and the corresponding A, what the corresponding A for this B symbol, it is now popped out from the stack, and the tuple format description or instantaneous description, it is also called as a instantaneous description, or you can call it as ID. In short term, it is called as the ID. It is written like this, Q1 B. Now only one B is remaining, only one B is left here to read, and AZ0. So my stack becomes AZ0, and the input string contains only. So at this point of time, this is the only structure. State is Q1. The current input string is only containing B, means B is to be read only here, and the stack contain AZ0. This is the way. This is the structure. Now read this B. Now after reading this B, the machine moves to the next, that is nothing but the end of the string. That is moved toward the delta, and that is called as the end of the string. So this B is being read successfully, and the machine goes to the delta state. That is nothing but the EOF. end of the pile or end of the string, and the state is as it is Q0. And for this B, so whatever what was A was there, A is now popped out. The A symbol is now popped out from that particular stack. So I write here the tuple definition Q1 epsilon Z0, because there is no symbol is to be read in the input string. There is an empty string now, the string becomes empty, or there is no symbol, further symbol to be read by the PDA. And in the stack also, only a symbol remaining, and that is called only remaining is Z0, now become the top of the stack. Z0 is the top of the stack, right? Now, what is to be done next? So at this point of time, so all the 6 characters, AAA and BBB, read successfully. Means initially, for the first 3A, we are pushing this A inside the stack. And as soon as the PDA encounters B, for each B, for this B, this A is pop. For the second B, second A is pop. And for third B, third A is popped from the stack. And we have got the empty string at the end, and the stack is also got empty here. So next state is like this. So we have to change the state from Q1. The state changes to Q0. The state changes to Q0 epsilon Z0, and that is Q2 epsilon Z0, and Q2 is nothing but our accept state. Q2 is called as your accept state. So final structure will look like this. So at we have to change the state to Q2. Getting this point? So this is the way how the PDA pushdown automata works. So PDA works on the very simple principle. The string is given, input string is given. Just go on reading the string one by one, and as soon and the state is same. See, for example, for push operation, the state is same. For push operation, you have to keep the state as the same, and you have to go on putting whatever symbol you are going to read. Just push it inside the stack. Push it inside the stack, and as soon as you encounter different characters, suppose A string is there, you go on pushing A inside the stack. The state is Q0. Now, as soon as you encounter B, so you have to start popping from the stack. You have to start popping from that particular stack. The state changes to Q1. State changes to Q1. And up to what? Up to end of the string, you have to perform the same operation. And as soon as you reach to the end of the string, you have to change the state so that your string becomes empty as well as your stack becomes empty. So meaning is that the string is successfully read by the PDA. So this indicates Q2 is the final state. Just like our automata, if we reach to the final state, so we can say that yes, the string is accepted by the automata. The same way here also we conclude that as we reach to the final state, we say that this particular string A raised to 3, B raised to 3 is successfully read by our automata, is successfully read by our automata. Getting this point? Okay, so let us see. Let us go to the next slide. Examples on pushdown automata. So see, we'll see one example here. Okay, so see this example very carefully. The PDA is given with this two states Q0, Q1, and the input symbols are ABC. These are the input symbol ABC, and these are the two stack symbol. This is nothing but your input alphabet. This is nothing but capital Q. Delta transitions Q0, Z0 is nothing but the top of the stack, and Q1 is nothing but your final state. Q1 is the final state, and these are the transitions. These are the PDA transitions they have already given. These are the PDA transition already given for this, right? So we have to. What is the question? Question is here. Show that the acceptance of ABB CBBA by the above PDA. We have to show that this particular PDA. So this is actually our PDA. This is actually our PDA. Means the PDA is represented in the format of your instantaneous description. So in the instantaneous description means it is nothing but the transitions. These are nothing but the transitions, and the PDA is represented in the form of transitions or IDs. So IDs are given to us, and it is asked to prove that or show that this particular string is being accepted by this PDA. The rules or the transitions which are given for this PDA, that we have to check. That we have to check. So let us start with the tuple rule or with the instantaneous description. So let us here Q0. Start with the state Q0. Now take the string here A B B C B B A Z0. Then, so here, so if this is the way, and they have given rule number one, this is rule number two, rule number three, then rule number four, rule number five, and rule number six, for example. So we'll just number this rule. 1, 2, 3. This is 1, 2, 3. Then 4. So this is 3. Q0. Okay, this is 5, and this will become 6. So 6 rules are given here. 6 rules are given. Delta Q0 A Z0. So see, observe. So first understand the rules. Understand the PDA given. So PDA says that if the state is Q0, if the current state is Q0. So always remember Q into sigma into stack symbol, that gives us next state and next stack symbol that we are getting here. So PDA tells that, or the definition of PDA says that Q0 current input string is A and the stack is Z0. Then you have to the output is Q0A. So the next, this is A is nothing but our the next toe symbol which we are getting here. Meaning is that this is nothing but our push operation. This is our push operation, right? So if A is here in the string, if we encounter A, small a in the string, and a stack, there is no symbol in the string, and the stack is empty, then we have to push this A inside the stack. Then we have to push this A inside the stack. So this first rule is push operation. Now come to the second rule. Second rule says that if the current state is Q0, see it carefully, if the current state is Q0, the input, you encounter a B in the input string, whatever it may be, at the start, in the middle, or at the end. If you encounter B as a symbol, right, and on the stack, the A is there, right? So here, if I write here Q0, B, and on the stack, A is there, then what you have to do, then also you have to QB, means your next stack symbol is B. And the state is Q0, means what you are doing here, you are pushing that particular B on the stack. This is also a push operation. This is also a push operation. Getting this point, how to understand the ID description or the rules. So Q0 A, so that is nothing but our current state is Q0. A is the input, current input string, a current input symbol read, and the stack symbol is empty. So you have to push this in, with the help of this rule. It says that Q0A means you have to push A in the stack. So here push B in the stack. This rule BA, Q0B, meaning is that this B you have to push here in the stack. These are the rules. These are actually PDA rules. Now next, Q0C, if in the input you encounter the symbol C and the top of the stack is B. So you encountered C and the top of the stack is B. Then what is the rule C? Now see here, the state changes from Q0 to Q1 and epsilon. So this, whenever you encounter the epsilon sign, that indicates this is nothing but your pop operation. You are not going to push B here, you are not going to push C here, but whatever may be the top of the stack, whatever may be the top of the stack is B, so you have to push, so you have to pop B. Getting this point? So see it carefully, observe it carefully. So Q0CB, that is equal to Q1 epsilon, meaning is that current input symbol is C and the current stack, top of the stack is B. Current stack stack symbol is B. So rules tell that you have to change the state from Q0 to Q1, and epsilon means this, whatever may be the B is here, so this B will be removed from the top of the stack. Getting this point? Means you are going to pop B. So your first operation is push A. Second operation is push B. Third operation is push, means as soon as you find C here, you have to pop the B, right? Then C here. Next, number rule number four. State is Q1. The current input symbol is A and current stack symbol is also A. Then also you have to pop A. This is for pop A. Top of the stack is A. So if we want to pop A, you have to use this rule. So delta Q1 AA, meaning is that current input is A, and top of the stack you find A. Top of the stack we find A here. Then you have to write the rule. The rule is given Q1. So state remains as it is Q1. Epsilon indicates you have to pop this A symbol. Epsilon indicates you have to pop the symbol A. Now come to here. Fifth rule is Q0. the input is B. Suppose your input symbol is B, and on the top of the stack is also B. And on the top of the stack, B is there, then also Q0B. Then Q0B means what you are doing here? You are pushing this B, means you are again push B. This here, B is now push inside the stack. We are pushing B inside the stack, right? The next rule, there are rule number 6, Q1. Now, if the state is Q1, so here if the state is Q1, top of the input string is B and the top of the stack is B, then you have to, then Q1 epsilon, meaning is that this B is pop. So you have to pop B. Getting this point? So these are the rules. So first rule tells that you have to push A. Second rule tells that you have to push B. Then third is push, pop B, pop A, push B and pop B. So these many 6 rules are the PDA is defined by these different 6 rules, right? And the now the question, now come to the question. Question is that we have to check the acceptance of this particular string by the PDA. Whether this string is being accepted by the PDA or not. So see here, now just write in the tuple format. I have written just like this. Q0, comma, A, B, B, C, B, B, A. This is the given string and the currently stack is empty. Only Z0 is there. Only Z0 symbol is there. So observe here. So A, the input pointing to A and the Z0. So which rule we have to follow here? Now, which rule you have to follow here? So for this, this Q0, A, Z0, where is the rule? This is the rule. Q0, A, Z0. Meaning is that what we have to do here? We have to Q0A means we have to push A into the stack. Push A into the stack. That's why we have written here. And remove A from this particular string. So the string becomes Q0, BBC, BBA, comma, AZ0. And this is as per the rule number 1. This is from our rule number 1. Getting this point? Getting this point? Right. So means we have to check Q0A, Z0. So Q0 A Z0 indicates that, or this rule tells us that we have to push A into the stack. So here we have pushed this A into the stack. Right? And the A is, so that A is pushed. So definitely the A is not here, means we have read A. So next the pointer come to B. Now the pointer or this one can say the pointer come to B, and here the top of the stack is now A. Top of the stack is now A. Right. So see, now you tell me the rule. What is the rule? Q0BA. So if this is the situation, Q0BA, then what is to be followed? So see here, the rule number tells us that if the situation like this, Q0, the input is B and the top of the stack is A, then what we have to do here? We have to Q0B means we have to push B. We have to push B. So as per the rule number 2, we have pushed B in the stack. So pointer moves to next B, so next B, and here see the changes in the stack. So B is now pushed inside the stack. B is now pushed inside the stack here. Getting this point? This is as per the rule number 2. So here rule number 1 is followed for this, and we got the structure like this. The rule number 2 is followed this, and we got the structure here BAZ0. Getting this point? Now see the structure. So B at the input is B, and the top of the stack is also B, and the state is Q0. State is Q0. Right. So by rule number 4, Q0, B, B. So push B. We have to also push B inside the stack. So by using rule number 5, so we are going to push this B inside the stack. So stack becomes B, B, A, Z0, and the string is now C, B, B, A. And the string is now C, B, B, A. This is as per the rule number 5. It is rule number 5. Right? Now see, input is C. Input character is C. And the top of the stack is B. State is Q0. CB. C rule number 3. Input Q0. C as the input character and the stack top is the B. So you have to change the state to Q1. And epsilon in the indicates pop B. Whatever is the top of the stack, you are going to pop that B. Means this B is now to be pop in the using that the rule number 3. So using rule number 3, so C is now completely read here. So string remaining only BBA, and this B is being popped out. So the top of the stack becomes this B. and this is from our rule number 3. So this output we have received from the rule number 3, and this is the final output. Means this is the one can say the outcome of this Q1. The state changes from Q0 to Q1. The string characters are only B, B, A, and the top of the stack is B, A, Z, 0. This is the case. Now, again, see, so that's why they are bold here. That's why they marked as a bold here, B, B. Q1, B, B. Where is the rule? Rule is here, Q1, B, B. And rule says that Q1 epsilon means we have to pop B. Epsilon means the whatever may be the top of the stack, epsilon indicates that symbol is to be popped out from the stack. So B is to be popped. So this B, which is on the stack, that is to be popped out here. So the next, it becomes Q1. So BA as it is, and B is now popped out. That's why the stack remains only AZ0. AZ0, and it is as per rule number 6. This is from the rule number 6, right? Okay, now see here, Q1, the input string, input character is B, and the stack character is A. So Q1 BA. So where is the rule? Q1 BA. So Q1 BA is there. So if this is the case, then what we have to do here? If this is the case, then also we have to pop that particular A from the stack. So using this rule, we are going to pop. So only symbol remaining is Q1 A and AZ0. A is now popped out. A must not be here. So A is popped out from the stack. So A is there, Z0 is there. So we have removed all this A is from the stack. And finally, we have got this Q1 epsilon Z0. Q1 epsilon Z0. So meaning is that at the end, we have got the empty string. So as soon as we reach to the empty string C, B, B, A, we reach to the empty string. Meaning is that this particular string is accepted. It is accepted by the given PDA. This particular string is being accepted by the given pushdown automata. Getting this point? So observe it carefully. There is no any difficulty. Only we have to take care. Initially, in case of our finite automata, we are only considering Q into input, and we are going to change the state. But now here, along with Q into input, we have to also see the toe, that is nothing but the stack character, and the two things we are getting here, Q into stack character. It is very simple. There is no difficulty. Means we have to see the input character and the stack character. Input character and the stack character. And the rules are already defined. These are the rules that are already defined here. And from this rule, we are going to make the transitions as per the given here. And we are able to reach. And if we are able to reach successfully to the empty string or to the final state, we conclude that yes, the string is being accepted by the finite automata. Getting this point? So this is the way how we are solving the examples on the pushdown automata. So just look at this. So PDA given with this, these rules are there, and we have to solve by one by one. We have to solve it by one by one. So first, this is by rule 1, this is by rule 2, and so some numbers are mistaken here. So you can have your rule number 4 is here actually. This is the rule number 6, right? So this is the way, right? Okay, so there are few more examples, but I think we have to stop here. Remaining example, we will discuss in the next session, right?